हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम प्रोफेसर नयना स्नेह, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी, पार्वतीबाई ज्ञान बामोजे कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग, वाघोली, पुणे. सो इन द लास्ट सेशन वी हैव सीन द रिक्वायरमेंट कैप्चरिंग फंक्शन, इंसेप्शन एंड इलिस्टेशन. इन दिस सेशन वी आर स्टार्टिंग विद द रिक्वायरमेंट इलैबोरेशन. सो इन दिस टास्क द इंफॉर्मेशन टेकन फ्रॉम द यूजर ड्यूरिंग द इंसेप्शन एंड द इलिस्टेशन फेज इज एक्सपांडेड, रिफाइंड एंड इलैबोरेटेड. That means whatever the information is collected from the user in the initial phase, in inception and elicitation, is expanded in more detail in the elaboration phase. So the elaboration means work in a detail, go with the details of each and every requirements. It means the task is developing the pure model of the software using the function, features and the constraints of the software. That is nothing but whatever the requirements collected from the customers, we have to select the functions, what features are included in the things and what constraint should be applied for the particular requirements. This phase will give the detailed view of the customer requirements. So the elaboration is analysis, modeling action. This focus on how the end user will interact with the system. So next is the requirement negotiation. In the negotiation task, a software engineer decides how the project will be achieved with the limited business resource. If the project team is small and the requirements are the big, so we need to prioritize some requirements from the customer and we need to select the requirement from the customers so we can achieve the requirements developing phase within a limited business resources. This is done by the negotiation. So the task includes to create the rough cases of the development and assess the impact of the requirement on the project cost and the delivery. Whatever the impact will be happen of that requirement, we have to guess the project cost and delivery depend on that. Then one need to go with the negotiation with the customer or with the stakeholders. That means if there are the different numbers of users or the different numbers of stakeholders, which will give the different requirements to the developer. So one should go with the negotiation because all the requirements given by the stakeholders cannot be implemented. We need to negotiate the requirement, prioritize the requirement, and the requirement which are necessary to develop the system, we need to select them and develop them. Other which are the special requirements or which we can say the second prioritized requirement which we can keep. So this is also called as a win-win condition, in which the user also wins, or the end users or the customers or the stakeholder also wins, and the developer also wins. That means we achieve the things, we achieve the business cost, business we can say the project cost or the project delivery within a time, within a limited resource, with all the requirements stated in the priority list from the user. So in this step, the customer and developer and the stakeholder decides to decode first to rank the requirement. To rank the requirement means to list the requirements. Second is to decide the prioritize, means whatever the requirement are listed, we need to select the requirements from the list. That is prioritize the requirement which are given from the customer. Third is to decide the risk. Whatever requirement we have selected, we need to see what risk will be encountered if we select this requirement. So we need to decide the risk, what risks will be encountered in the system if we develop the requirement. And fourth is finalize the project cost. Depend on the requirements, we need to final the project cost and impact of all the issues on the project cost, delivery and the date. So whatever requirements we have selected, whatever the risk is there, whatever the project cost is there, so we need to consider all the things for the project cost, for delivery time and the date. So the next one is the requirement specification. In this task, the requirement engineering construct the final work product. Now the specification phase will give the final work product, but in form of the requirements, in form of the specialized requirements. So the work product product is in the form of the software requirement specification. Now this is also called as SRS, that is the software requirement specification. In this, a particular template and the structure is formed for the particular software, which will give what requirement need to be developed, what will be the developed strategy and rough idea about the requirements. In this task, formalize the requirement to propose the software, such as the informative, functional, and the behavior. So, the requirement specification may take any form. It may be your graphical or the textual formats. So, it can be also written in a written document. Then, with a set of graphical models, then we can have the formal mathematical models. You have done a mathematical model in the projects also. So, this is one type of requirement specification of the system. And fourth is the collection of scenarios. Then scenarios may take the different diagrams. You can say the use case diagrams, the data flow diagrams, control flow diagrams. And the fifth one is the prototype. So define the architecture. Depend on the SRS, software requirement specification, we can also write the prototype. So this is the requirement specification. Specification is nothing but the final product in the form of requirement specification document, or we can say software requirement specification. So the next is the requirement specification. If the question is asked about the elements of analysis model, so you have to explain the elements. The first is the scenario based element, which is under the requirement specification. So first is the scenario based element, second is the class based element, third is the behavioral based element, and fourth is the flow oriented element. So in the scenario based element, you have the use cases, different use cases. We'll see the example laterly. Second is the class based, in which the class diagram is there and collaboration diagrams are there. The third is the behavioral based elements, that is the sequence diagram and the state stories. And the flow oriented, in which we will have the flow charts, your data flow diagram from 0 to 2, 3, 4 levels, and control flow diagrams, that we can say also say the activity diagrams. So these are the element of analysis model. Might be there is a question on the analysis model, so you have to explain all with the proper example. We'll see the example laterly. So the last is the requirement validation. So whatever the work product is built as an output of the requirement engineering, that is access for the quality throughout the validation steps. So whatever we whatever requirements are refilled, whatever requirements are prioritized, and until the specification phase, all these requirements are validated in particular manner. So we have the different formal technical reviews, the inception is there, then we have the technical lead teams meetings, walkthroughs are there. So these are the different techniques to validate the requirements which are taken from the customer, which are prioritized, or which are written in a SRS, that is software requirement specification. So whatever requirements we have refilled or refined from the rough, we will validate the requirements. So the constraints of the systems, then domain constraints or any other ambiguity or the risk might not be happened in the system. So we have the different requirement validation checklist. So first, all the requirement must be stated clearly. So what the validation step will check, all the requirement are stated clearly or not. So are the requirement misinterpreted? Then does the requirement violate or any system domain constraints? Then requirement are traceable to the systems system module or that is created or not? So are the requirement associated with the performance, behavior, and the operational characteristics? So all this checklist is validated against the requirement which are collected from the customer and which are refilled and prioritize. So the last one is requirement management. So it is the activity that helps the project team to identify, control, and track the requirements, and changes can be made to the requirement at the any type of ongoing project. So if some if they identify some ambiguity or some risk due to some particular requirement, so that what the requirement management will do, they will just check the things and rechange the requirement. They can change the requirement on the basis of if there is some ambiguity, if some system constraints are violated, or some risk is happening because of some requirement which is stated in priority list. So we can change that requirement. That is done under the requirement management phase. So this task start with the identification and assigning a unique identifier to each requirements. After finalizing the requirements are traceable, traceability table is developed. For example, traceability table are the features, then resources, dependency, subsystems, and the interfaces of the requirement. So such table is defined by the team, and then we'll find what requirements are dependent on other requirement, or is there any external dependency to the requirement, or any ambiguity or any bug or any risk at some risk factor. So this all is trace and identified, and then if such changes are needed, then that changes are done using the requirement management phase. So this is the UML diagrams. So this part comes under the requirement analysis. We'll see in the next lecture. Just we'll start with the UML in Afropa parts. So if you have any query regarding the requirement capturing, in which we have seen the 8 functions of the requirement analysis from inception to last requirement management, if you have any query, you can comment or you can say in the Zoom section, which will be conducted after this unit. So, thank you.